There's a reason work smart, not hard is a cliche. Effective studying more about how you study, not just how long. Studying TV focuses on getting the most out of every study session, and you should too. But for now, today's video.
The question, why should I study alone rather than in a group? This is actually something I get asked time to time. Group studies are not meant for everyone. At the same time, studying alone all the time isn't recommended too. You might be a person who likes their space and to study without interruption from others, and if that's who you are, you fare well by studying alone without involving in group studies. If you can get information on your own, manage to keep a track on your progress and have a strategy that is meant to work for you, you should be doing single study. At the same time, there are people who get anxious and can't decide on what to read if they are single. They are the kind of people who involve in group studies because for them group studies is a form of motivation and keep them in track. They take strength in being among the same kind of people going through what they are going. It also helps that the other person has something more to contribute and you don't have to spend the same million hours getting that information when you could get it in a few hours. Neither is bad. Some prefer one technique and some, the other one. You should choose what fits your personality. But then, the best way to prepare is always to go for single study with group discussions in between, once in a week. These group discussions differ from group studies in a way that these are an additional tool to know what you have missed out in your preparation. They don't make up for the methodology of study. I always say, the other person may not be able to reach your style of reading or catch up with your speed, but if there is anyone who can, it's gotta be you. You know how you read, nobody else does. However, it doesn't mean you know everything. It's good to take help now and then. In fact, you should. If asked for my opinion, I say, single because for me groups feel cumbersome and suffocating. But, that's me. I prefer studying alone. Similarly, you must have a preference. Do that. Pick that one which you are most comfortable with, and it's not wrong to keep switching between one and the other method too. And that would be why you should choose studying in single, if it's your preference. Good luck. For more answers, or more advice on effective studying, check out the links in the description below.